Okay, hello and welcome to 3ds Max. This tutorial will be for beginners and getting started of how to use 3ds Max. Like every 3D modeling package, you will basically have four viewports, three orthographic ones, and then a perspective. Along you have different toolbars with many different functions. So let's get started. The top toolbar is your standard generic toolbar. You go File, New Document, Open, Save, Import, Export, Exit of course. You've got Edit for copy and pasting, cloning, and then a few different tools at the bottom. Under Tools you have things like mirroring objects, array tool which I'll show you later, and renaming objects, which is very handy. I haven't particularly used the other ones, however hopefully I might be able to show you them. Grouping is very simple. It's grouping and ungrouping objects, make easier selections. Create will be the exact same as this panel over here, so I wouldn't worry about that. The next one I'll show is rendering. You have your render, rendering setup, and rendered frame window, which I'll show you in a bit. And we shouldn't worry about the rest. In fact, under Help and 3ds Max Help, there's a very good document on just about everything in 3ds Max. So I'd suggest looking at that as well. Below that, you have your undo, redo. You have a select object. Next to that you have select by name, which will bring up a dialog. Every object in your scene will come along here, so you can select very easily. It's always useful to have good naming conventions for your models, so you can easily find them through here. You have your move tool for moving objects, rotating the same, and scaling, so you can scale them in different axes, your X, Y, and Z. Next you have the snaps, which snap it to this grid you can see in the orthographic views, and this is an angle snap toggle. Basically whenever you're rotating with this tool, everything will be snapped to 5 degrees, which can be very helpful. And again you have like a mirror tool, and then you've got rendering options here. So next I'll just quickly go over the bottom. This is like the animation panel, which I wouldn't worry yet because we're not going to be animating for a good while. And from there we have a few navigational buttons. You have a zoom, so if you click that you can zoom in and out of the scene in any viewport. You have zoom all, zoom everything, although we have no objects selected so that's not going to work. Let me see, we have pan view, which will essentially pan your scene just using the standard mouse click. Orbit, which is the same as rotating. I'll do it in this perspective viewport, as you can see there. And then this one's very handy. It's called Maximize Viewport Toggle. It'll make this viewport full screen. And again, just click it to get it off. Next, we will go over keyboard shortcuts, which is what I would use mostly for instead of these. So with the middle mouse button I can pan my scene. With the zoom wheel, or the wheel of the mouse even, I can zoom my scene. With Alt and middle mouse button I can rotate, and with the Z button I can zoom in on all my objects at once. And of course my favorite would be Alt and W to maximize the viewport, and Alt W again to turn that back to normal. You have four viewports: top, front, left, and perspective. Top, front, and left are all what is known as orthographic views. They will never change to perspective. So that's looking down in your scene, that's looking at the front, left. And then a perspective view is like a, well, essentially it is a perspective view. I'll show you what I'm on about whenever I make a box in a wee second. Select different viewports, I would suggest using the middle mouse button. Reason being, if you have an object selected and say you click onto the front viewport or any other viewport with your standard mouse click, you will deselect the object. Whereas if you hit the middle mouse, it'll select them without deselecting or selecting anything else. Okay, now for creating objects, or this panel here, you have your create panel, and from that you can create geometry, which is essentially your boxes, spheres, cylinders, and you have all different kinds of objects you can create, including 2D shapes, which can be lines, circles. You have lights for rendering purposes. You have photometric, real world lighting, and you have standard lighting. Note that I'm on 3ds Max 2009. Any previous version would have the photometric second and standard at the top, just in case you get confused there. Cameras are for, let me see. Cameras are used for a proper way of rendering. For example, you could have your perspective view here, you could have a box, whatever, and then say you like this view, you could create a camera right in this view, and then you go back to your perspective without changing your camera. It's a bit complicated, but I will show you later. You can also animate your camera for like a walkthrough of say a house or a scene, whatever. Helpers, I wouldn't really use any of these except for the tape, which is like a measuring tape. Space warps for like wind effects, gravity, it's more animation really. And systems, you have your bones, sunlight, biped. The bones and biped are for animation. Say you build a character in 3ds Max, the bones will go in the relevant places and you can then animate that very easily. Daylight is another lighting system. So then you have your modify panel for modifying a single piece of geometry which you make in this. You have the hierarchy panel. It's for changing the pivot of an item. You know, motion, it's for animation. Display can be used to hide objects, to freeze objects. I'll show you that soon. And utilities, just for several miscellaneous things to do. Okay, so I'm going to wrap that up. Next, I'm going to show you how to create objects and modify objects. So, thanks for watching.